So the problem last lecture I have given it to you people. Just I'm going to summarize what we have seen in last lecture. So load balancing concept. If load is point load, and when tendon is flushed with some eccentricity and bent tendon, we have to consider the upward forces due to the inclination of this tendon, bent tendon, and that if this pre-stressing force is P, okay, so this component of this force, inclined force, vertical component is P sine theta. If you are going to consider this theta, and this is P sine theta, and if you are going to consider this force as a W, so these two vertical forces are going to counterbalance this W. So net intensity of this W is going to reduce. So net vertical force. So net vertical force will be W minus 2 P sine theta. So this is main concept of load balancing, and by considering this concept, okay, we have to calculate the net force, and due to that moment is going to reduce, WL by 4. That moment is net W is going to reduce, then that automatically that moment also going to reduce. Okay, so by considering this, we have solved one problem, and one problem I have given to you people. So tell me that problem given data. So first tell me the cross sectional area of that problem B and D. I think B is 400 mm, D is 600 mm. What is pre-stressing force given in the problem? Tell me the pre-stressing force. Whether I'm audible to people?
1000 kilonewton.
Given data and problem.
P is equal to 1000, sir.
Okay. What else data?
L is 8 meter.
L length of beam is 8 meter. So by considering this data, now you people know that to get the stresses, we have to use formula P by A plus minus M by Z. So this formula we have to use. So in this formula, which thing required? Pre-stressing force they have given. Area we have to calculate. So cross-sectional area. Step number first. So cross-sectional area here, A is equal to 400 by 600 mm. So area will be. Sanga kodithirungala calculate karun.
2.4 into 10 to power 5.
2.4 into 10 raised to 5.
Power 5
mm. Okay. Next thing is section modulus. Z we have to calculate. So what will be the section modulus? BD square by 6. So B is here 400. 600 cube divided by 6. So section modulus Z will be?
Sir, square, sir. BD square.
BD square.
BD square, sorry. So BD square by 6.
24 into 10 raised to 6.
24 into 10 raised to
6.
6 mm cube.
Cube.
Okay. This is section modulus. So moment we have to calculate now. So this beam is subjected with UDL. Okay. Self weight of beam plus the point load. So moment when you are going to calculate. Moment you have to consider WL by 4. Plus small w l square by 8. This moment due to point load and this moment due to self weight of beam. Self weight of beam. Okay. How we are going to get this w is? So this w they have given 200 k. Okay, now we have to consider the net W. So net W will be by considering the effect vertical component of the forces that we have to consider. Okay, so here net W while calculating, we are going to consider capital W minus 2P sine theta. And the value here, net W, I'm going to say WN, W net will be here. So W 200 into 2 into P is here 1000 and sine
200 theta, minus
and theta here, sorry, 200 minus.
Yes.
Sine theta is here. So theta is front side divided by adjacent side. So front side is here 140. Okay. So that this value in problem given 160 mm. So remaining side in front of that theta will be 140 because this total beam depth is 600 mm. So half depth of beam will be 300. So 160, 300 minus 160, that value will be 140. So sine theta here, theta value will be 140 divided by half length of the beam. So total beam length is 8 meter. If you are going to take half distance, half length of beam, it is 4 meter. So that value, if you are going to consider in mm, so that value is 4000 mm. So if you are going to put this all value in the formula, you are going to get that value W. So tell me the value of W, net W.
130.
So
130.
W.
130.2.
130.
Just 130, sir.
130 kN. It will be the net force, that vertical force. Okay. So after getting this net force 130, calculating the bending moment, okay, moment due to bending, okay, for that we have to use formula WL square by 8. So in this, what we have to consider W, okay, so that W is self weight of beam. So self weight of beam is, what is size of beam given? 0.4. Into 0.6 into density of concrete 25. So that value will be
6
newton meter.
6 kilonewton per meter.
6 N
kilonewton per meter.
Meter. Okay. So after getting the value for moment, so I'm going to calculate bending moment value. So W is here 6, length is 8 square divided by 8. So bending moment due to self weight of beam will be 48 kN meter. Okay, now we have to calculate net bending moment. So net bending moment will be W net L by 4 plus W L square by 8. So W net we have calculated 130 kN, okay, into 10 dash to 3 into L length, that length is 8 meter by 4 plus this 48 into 10 dash to 6. So tell me the net bending moment.
Three zero eight into ten raised to six.
Newton mm. Newton mm. Okay, so this how you have got the moment. Now after getting the moment, we are going to calculate the stresses. Okay, so we are going to put the value of stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. So stresses at the top fiber of the beam. So what are the stresses at top fiber of the beam? P by A, okay, plus M by Z. So we are going to calculate the stresses now. So put the value here. The P is 1000 into 10 raised to 3 divided by cross sectional area, which we have calculated is 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 plus moment here 308 into 10 raised to 6 and section modulus we have calculated as 24 into 10 raised to 6. So please check the moment value. I think something going wrong here. WL by 4. Whether it is correct? Check the calculation. 308 into 10 raised to 6. 308 kN meter is the moment value. Check whether this is correct.
Correct, sir.
Correct. So put the value here and tell me the stresses.
12.83 Newton
per mm. First, tell me the direct stress value, this section value.
4.17
4.17
16.
And M by Z?
12.83
So tell me the total stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam.
17 Newton per mm square.
Hello.
17 Newton per mm square. 17 Newton per mm square.
17 Newton per mm square. Okay. So after getting the stresses at top fiber of the beam, next we are going to calculate stresses at bottom fiber of the beam. So stresses at bottom fiber of the beam, sigma b will be here, P by A minus M by Z. So after putting the value here, sigma b, so P by A you have calculated 4.17 and M by Z you have calculated 12.13. So sigma b will be here.
8.66
8.66
newton per mm square.
But this value negative. Is in negative. Okay, so this stress is in tension. So next thing here, after getting the both values, stresses at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam, sigma b, we have to draw the sketch now. So for cross section of 400 by 600, okay, if I'm going to consider this is central axis and tendon here, you can see placed at a distance 160 mm from bottom. So this is 140 mm. Okay, and direct stress we have calculated. So this is direct stress P by A. We have calculated the direct stress value 4.17 newton per mm square positive. Here also same 4.17 newton per mm square. Okay, and next we have calculated the stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam. So we have considered M by Z bending stresses, M by Z bending stresses, and that value we have calculated as 12.83 newton per mm square. Here also 12.83 newton per mm square, and total addition, that net value, this is positive, this is negative at top fiber and bottom fiber of the beam. So net values we have calculated as top fiber value is 17 and bottom fiber value as 8. So this is 17. This value, if you are going to consider, is 8. So P by A plus M by Z, this value is in positive, this is in negative. So P by A minus M by Z. So this value we have calculated minus 8.66 newton per mm square. And top value we have calculated as a 17 newton per mm square. So this is how we are going to solve the problem by using load balancing concept. Okay, got it? Any problem in this? Any query regarding this problem? Whether you understood the procedure or not, again, I will repeat the procedure. Load balancing concept. The main thing I have told you, if point load is going to act on beam, the tendon profile you have to place as a bent tendon. Advantage of bent tendon, due to this inclination, we are going to get this theta. And due to this theta inclination, we are going to resolution of these forces, we are going to get the two forces, P sine theta, P sine theta. This addition of these two, 2P sine theta, is going to counteract and going to reduce the intensity of this upward force. Sorry, downward force, and you can see your net force is going to reduce, W minus 2P sine theta. Okay, and then we have considered one problem. In that problem, the width of beam is given 400 mm, depth of beam 600, pre-stressing force going to act as a value 1000 kN, that total point load going to act on beam is 200 kN, and length of beam 8 meter. So first thing, based on given data, we have calculated the cross-sectional area 400 by 600. So that value is 2.4 into 10 raised to 5 mm square. We have calculated the section modulus by using formula BD square by 6. After putting the values, you have got this answer, that 24 into 10 raised to 6 mm cube. We have to calculate now moments on the beam for the point load as well as the self weight of beam. So self weight of beam is going to act as a UDL. And for UDL, this UDL is going to act on in kN per meter. So for that UDL, we have to consider W square by 8. So for given W, we have to calculate the net W. So for net W, W minus 2 pi sine theta. Already I have told you here what why we have to consider 2 pi sine theta, because of these two vertical component forces. And after considering that, we have got the net value WN. So that W, by considering this 200 and 2 pi sine theta, we have got the value here 130 kN. And then we have to calculate the bending moment, okay, due to the self weight of beam. So self weight of beam here, cross sectional area of beam 0.4 into 0.6 into density of the concrete 25. So we have got here self weight of beam 6 kN per meter. By considering that 6 kN per meter W, we have calculated the bending moment WL square by 8. So that value is 48 kN per meter. And then we have to calculate the net bending moment by considering the point load as well as the self weight of beam. So net point load 130 into 10^3 to length of beam 800 mm divided by 4 into 48 into 10^6. This is bending moment in Newton per mm. Sorry, Newton mm. And so net bending moment you have got 308 kN meter. After getting this value, we have to calculate the stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam. So top fiber first, direct stresses P by A, we have to calculate it, and that value is 4.17 positive. And then M, bending stresses positive, because our top part is going to be in a compression. So M by Z here. So the net moment value we have calculated, and the section modulus. After putting this, we have got this value 12.83. Addition of this all two is 70 Newton per mm square. So these are the stresses at top fiber of the beam. You can call this as a sigma T, because top fiber of the beam. Same way, we have to calculate the stresses at bottom fiber of the beam. So stresses at the bottom fiber of the beam, sigma B. P by A minus M by Z, because tension is at bottom of the beam, bottom fiber of the beam. So here we have to consider the negative sign. So stresses, already we have calculated the direct stresses and bending stresses. So 4.17 minus 12.83. So direct stresses, bending stresses, okay, at bottom fiber of the beam will be minus 8.33 Newton per mm square. And in the form of the diagrams, we are going to put the value here like this. P by A, the direct stresses will be in compression. So that is positive. And the bending stresses, you can say this as a direct stresses. Direct stresses, and these are the bending stresses, and this is combined stresses. These are the combined stresses. Okay, after putting the bending stresses here in the diagram, positive at top, negative stresses at bottom, and combination of these all two, direct stresses and bending stresses, combined stresses will be, so this is positive, positive, addition of P by A plus M by Z will be 70 Newton per mm square. And here direct stresses minus bending stresses will be 8.66 Newton per mm square in negative. So this is stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam at midsection. Okay, any problem, any queries regarding this? काय डाऊट नाही त्याच्याबद्दल सगळं क्लास इनॅक्टिव्ह दिसत मला ओके इफ यू डोंट हॅव एनी क्वेरीज एनी डाऊट हियर we are going to see the next part. So take one more problem. Whether I'm audible to people?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So take this problem. Following figure shows, draw the figure and write the problem. And tell me the stresses at top fiber and the bottom fiber of the beam. Hope that everyone can see this problem on the screen.
Yes, sir.
Let me know when you complete the problem, that question. Okay, try to solve the problem. And show me the solution now. So hope that all have written the problem or taken the screenshot. I'm going to stop the screen sharing.